Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today we're checking out this 6-year-old Dell Latitude E5440 from way back in 2014. Before we begin, make sure you like, subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any upcoming videos. Having an Intel Core i5 and 8GB of RAM works totally fine for web browsing and typing up documents. Speaking of typing documents, the keyboard found on the laptop feels like an Alienware 15 or an Area 51M keyboard. The trackpad, however, is mediocre. I upgraded this laptop from Windows 7 to Windows 10 Pro. The screen size is 14 inches and has a 60Hz refresh rate. Playing games like Roblox is not that bad, even though the laptop lacks a dedicated graphics chip. CSGO was playable on the Intel HD 4400 series graphics, that is the plan, when most of the settings were at low or medium. I was getting about 40 FPS and 10 or 20 in battle.
I'm throwing a grenade.
Fortnite was also playable, but with all settings at low or off. Lots of lag there. The dual core 4th generation i5 clocked at 2.6 GHz on turbo and 2.0 GHz on base, paired with 8GB of DDR3 RAM at 1600 MHz, was fine. Good for 2014, but not good for streaming. Video editing on DaVinci Resolve was no problem, even though I don't use 4K footage. Battery life is decent with that 90 watt hour extended battery. Got about 4 hours normal use and about half an hour in gaming. You might want to plug in the battery for extra performance. Ports wise, this laptop is the best that you could ask for, with 3 USB-A ports, RJ45 Ethernet, HDMI, VGA and a CD-DVD drive. That's literally every single thing you could ask for. Well, Thunderbolt 3 didn't exist at the time, so, you know. So guys, all in all, this laptop was really good for a laptop from 2014. It had a nice dual core 4th generation Intel i5. I'm saying 4th generation is nice because it's from 2014. And it had 4GB of RAM, which I forgot to mention. And I upgraded to 8, that's why it's 8 in the video. So, and it had also, another thing that I forgot to mention is that it has a 256GB SSD. From SK Hynix, yeah. And both the RAM sticks are SK Hynix. The one that I upgraded was Samsung. Yes, Samsung. So, anyway, hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. That was bad. Let's try it again. Come on. Okay, hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. Thumbs if you liked it, subs if you loved it. See you guys next time. This one's final. Okay, one last time. Sub to my channel, please. The channel's over here. If and also check out my most popular video, which is the video on the LG OK55 up here, and whatever video you might like, it'll be down here. Goodbye.